Hi, amateur chefs. Welcome and welcome back to my channel, Amateurish. Today, we're going to be making the famous Hilton Double Tree Cookies. I tried it two different times because I did mess up the first time, but I wanted to show you guys my experience anyway. These are the ingredients that I'll be using, and it'll be in the description box below. Let's get started. All right, first up, we're gonna use the 2 sticks of butter. You do wanna leave these sitting out a little bit so they can soften up. I did let them stay out for about 30 to 45 minutes and they still weren't as soft as I needed them to be. Next up, we're adding the white sugar and then now the brown sugar. The measurements are gonna be in the description box below, so I just wanted to kind of show you guys what I'm adding. The first step is mixing the butter and the sugar together. You're gonna mix this on medium speed for about 2 minutes until they're fully incorporated. All right, so this should be how it kind of looks once they get fully incorporated. And then you're going to add the 2 eggs and then the freshly squeezed lemon juice. I used exactly 1 lemon, probably wasn't exactly what they called for, but that's what I did. And then I added some vanilla extract. Again, I don't know if it was exact measurement, I just kind of threw it in there. And then you're gonna let it mix up on low speed for a couple of seconds, about 30 to 45 seconds, and then you're gonna speed it up on medium heat until it is all nicely incorporated. Okay, I told you guys that I failed the first time. I don't know if this was a fail, but if you look at this batter, for some reason, it started to split up. It looked like it was starting to curd, and I never got the consistency of like a smooth consistency with this. So I did start over a little bit, and I didn't get that. But this was where I originally started to mess up. I think the lemon juice was way too much. So with baking, follow the recipe completely, guys. Okay, so once I got the batter into the right consistency, I added the flour, the rolled oats, and then the salt, the cinnamon, and I am mixing it around. I didn't want to over mix it, so I took it out of the mixer just to mix it by hand with my spatula until I got the right consistency. Again, everything is going to be in the description box below so you guys can see exactly what I put in there. So now that it is in the cookie dough consistency, I'm adding the crushed walnuts to it, and then now I'm adding the semi-sweet chocolate, and then I'm also going to add dark chocolate because I'm really not a fan of semi-sweet. Now the ingredients did not call for dark chocolate, but that's just my favorite, so I mixed it in. So again, we're just going to incorporate this into it as much as you can. One thing I do want to know, guys, in the description box below, do you prefer the cookie or the chocolate? This is the debate. Like, it's kind of like wings, if you like flats or the drumsticks. Do you prefer the cookie or do you prefer the chocolate? Now all I'm doing is rolling them together to make little balls. I did make these way too big, as you're gonna see pictures of my first batch. So they kind of clinked up together. Again, I'm not a baker, but I felt like it was fun to just try to experiment making these cookies because these are one of my favorites. I do travel a lot, and Hilton is one of my preferred places to stay. So this was my final product. I left it in the oven way too long. Clearly was not exactly what I was looking for. Now, though I did mess up, I wanted to try again. So I actually froze the batter, and then I made these balls again, and I made them a little bit smaller, and these were the final product. They were a little bit softer in that moment. These are the 2 batches. Both batches did taste good. The other ones were just a little bit harder. Some people like crunchier cookies. I don't. I like it to be really, really soft. So these are the 2 final products. If you like the crunchier texture, the first batter is it. If you prefer softer cookies, the second one after I froze it was better. But guys, these are the finishing 2 products. Again, I'm not a baker, so I just wanted to be a little creative and step outside of the box. for this video. If you haven't already, please be sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you know what went wrong in the first batter when I mixed it, let me know in the description box below as well if you are a baker. Other than that, I'll see you in my next video on Amateurish.